Smart Wargames here, let's talk about some less known or more exotic tactics which might be not so widespread, especially among newer players. You sometimes might encounter situations like somebody hiding behind a wall, being in a building or in this area. You would have to enter this area, which might be extremely dangerous without fire support. Or something like this, you know, there is a elevation and a depression. It often happens with rails or roads. Some guy is on the road here, or he's behind this wall, or sitting here. This would be one of the spots. And you try to approach him. Naturally, he might see you first and put some rounds into you, and you think, God damn it. And for situations like this, there might be a solution, as the game allows you to do some sort to use grenades, also even weapons, without LOS. Example, in this case, you see a gray line. The blue line shows here, but they would, I think, fire into their own spot. But this gray line here is gray means you are allowed to do something. But you don't have proper LOS line of sight or proper LOF line of fire, and it doesn't care that much. We will simply do it. I want to lob a grenade over it. I always recommend to split the squads for such a plan, as, let's see, he's carrying 13 grenades, he's carrying 5 grenades, so we will use this guy's. As big squads around walls, if you issue something like this, they will, sometimes it happens, they start to crawl around. It can be quite annoying. It takes ages. Smaller squads, you see, like this guy, because sometimes they need to get into a proper position before they will do it. So we will issue a target command on, this is basically 1-2 action spots if you talk in combat mission engine terms. And we don't have a LOS, definitely not. And let's see what happens. They will aim for it, but they won't fire. And you might see some, they will change a bit some of the position. That's what I mean about this crawling I talked. It requires sometimes a bit time until they are in some sort of position. Yeah, and one is already prepping a grenade and throwing it over the wall. And this is quite an effective tactic to keep in mind. And they will keep throwing grenades. They have a lot of grenades. Grenades, you know, the troops carry a lot of grenades, and most of them in a regular play through not often used, because they're either gunned down or need to use their service weapons. So for a situation like this, don't save your grenades if you have, I don't know, some guy hiding here. Do it. And even if somebody would be inside this building, if these aren't some hard crack fanatics, if you put enough grenades in front of them, yeah, for example this grenade, yeah, he threw this grenade right by random into the building. This would definitely cause some suppression on the building, and you have a second squad, this guy's for example, okay, what the hell did they, is it three squads, what I see? Yeah, Mike pressed something, Mike pressed scout team, looks like a scout, I don't know, whatever. You might have a second team or a scout, a second squad here, and you will keep throwing grenades over. They will use them. And then you can go in and might utilize the suppression they used. Or you might even have luck and they got wounded or killed. And yeah, I think this could be also possible, but sometimes you need to watch out that they don't fire into their own spot. They might discharge the service weapons in a situation like this. If you, I don't know, here, and let's say you are here, somebody's behind the wall covering, or hiding even. This is also some difficult, you approach and he fires into you. You can lob grenades onto the wall or behind the wall. They might discharge their weapons, but if you allow them, give them time, they will also throw grenades if they're close enough. I go out of granites. It takes sometimes time. I can't. Sometimes I throw, I don't know, 2-3 granites in a short succession. Sometimes it requires time. Sometimes I do nothing. This spot isn't that optimal. Best results you have is two spots. And that's also why I recommend to keep the team small that do the job, because it looks like they interfering with each other doing this job. Yeah, finally. You see, it takes sometimes quite a time. And you can also even basically lob a granite quite if somebody's hiding behind the wall. I mean, this granite would be already effective on him, but this would be even more lethal. And however, sometimes if you do this close stuff, I saw it here on this spot, might be because of the building, can't tell you what shenanigans in what under the hood is going on there. But you need to watch out that you don't do this on your own spot. This also looks same like this here, but they will now fire, I think, into the same spot here. They fire, this is some sort of one spot, and they might even, they might pin themselves, might even injure themselves with their own weapons. So always, if possible, go for the two spot throw. But it looks like on specific occasions you can do this lobbing basically over the wall. So this is the granites, how you can prep granites. And second tactic we will talk about is what I call pre-firing. Pre-firing is normally a term that you basically fire on a suspected enemy position, often used for CQC. When you enter a room, you will basically discharge your weapons from different angles or in order to cause suppression and confusion. But what I mean is a bit different. Let's see. Yeah, let's use the same squad. Ah, they are pinned. Give me two teams. Yeah, let's use this team. What I often do, or what's generally often done, is let's say enemy infantry is in this building, or you are inside in a building and want to enter next room. What you often do is either approaching the front of the enemy suspected interior building position, like I do here, and somebody is suppressing them, or you simply go John Wayne, whatever, and there might be a chance that you spot them on the go, but there's a high chance that you will spot them, because if you stand in front, the infantry basically looks through the windows inside of the building. And for most times it is enough and gives you a good chance to spot almost everybody in short amount of time in order to engage them. However, sometimes when the light conditions, the weather conditions, and the equipment, the training, whatever, is bad. Yeah, I don't know. Thick haze, night, no night vision. In World War II there is no night vision either, but in the modern games, to keep in mind, no night vision. Bad training could also be possible. It's quite difficult to spot them, even being here. It's even quite difficult to spot them being inside of the same building. You know, buildings, they look always this, but a building is somewhat obstructed. Real buildings don't look like this. They have different rooms, interiors, furniture. And this basically means if the light conditions aren't that good, somebody could hiding in there, or it would be difficult to locate them. Even if you would rush, what I sometimes do if guys are suppressed, I rush into the room in order to basically gain dominance over the room in a CQC situation. But both tactics might turn out quite destructive when somebody inside, because you are moving, somebody inside notices you, and he can basically take out a complete complete team or even squad by discharging his automatic weapon, whatever, especially in these conditions I talked about. And there's one thing you can use, also in combination with other tactics, is pre-firing. So we approach the building, let's say it's night, it's hazy, whatever. You expect there's somebody inside. If you close to a building, you can fire inside of it. It looks like this. And they will fire into the building. And you might not hit somebody by it, but you might keep the suppression. And they will still spot, they will still have time to better reconnaissance the interiors, but you still have the suppression effect because, let's say, you have a vehicle or whatever, which is suppressing the building. Sure, you should always come over the flank. Here is a vehicle firing into it, and you come over here. But as soon as you enter, it will become, you need to cease the fire, otherwise you might cause friendly fire. And this might be, they even use grenades, so also good. Yeah, can throw, and this works also. Are these buildings connected? No, unfortunately not. This is some building connected by door. This should also work. God damn it. Yeah, okay, this is a some big connected building. I'm looking for something like this. Do we need to run over there? Should be safe, you guys. And you can use this alongside another squad. They throwing grenades into it and whatever, and a second squad goes through the door inside. You have a better control over the situation than with a vehicle that is firing, I don't know, 50 machine gun into it. Yeah, you have better control over it. And you see, this pre-firing, or this whatever you want to call it, suppression, close suppression fire, can keep guys suppressing and might even freak them out. And they still manage trying to spot them. Like I said, most times I use simply this, approach a building and wait, and most times they discover it, but in bad conditions they might sit here and then somebody discharges his weapons and kills everybody here. And this might give you an option for the situations. Yeah, for the next video, wait. And then you still can enter the building, because this would be perhaps better if you would stand in front of the door and keep firing inside. Okay, somebody is running some random mission. God damn it. And this. Run! Yeah. I think in the coup d'etat mission, when I made the prison break, there was some room full with a, I don't know, football team of bad guys. And I also used this to get control of the situation. However, one downside is to keep in mind, especially at night and bad conditions, when you fire your weapon. In combat mission, it's always good to make the reality check. What would happen in reality if you uncharge in the darkness your weapon? Yeah, you would make yourself quite visible, muzzle flash, whatever. And this could also turn against you to some extent. I don't know, if there are 20 guys sitting inside, yeah, and they hardcore, whatever, they aren't impressed by your machine gun 42. They might even spot you faster and engage you, or somebody else will spot you and engage you. So always keep this in mind, that you will unreveal yourself by doing that. And then, I don't know, you can finish, and everybody's now suppressed inside there. And then you can go in fast or either quick. It depends. Sometimes I like to get really quick into a room, because they then can position surround them, you know. Sometimes there's really shenanigans going on in buildings. Like I said, there's some abstraction going on. It's real. A real building doesn't look like this empty here. It's you simply can't. Yeah. Put everything full with furniture and whatever. There's no other game that I think also does something like this. And it is abstracted for several reasons. But assume as you enter, and when you enter fast, sure, you might miss somebody. Quick gives you a better situation awareness. You could also do hunt. It depends on the situation and how you handle things, how aggressive you want to play. And sometimes it's better to get quickly into something and then dominate them. And sometimes a hunt might be good, but a hunt has also the disadvantage that they will go slowly in and one guy might get shot. This guy who enters the door might get shot and the rest will hold and think, okay, didn't work out. It depends, yeah. It's also player style. But yeah, keep this tactic, when you're in front of a building tile, you can fire into the interiors and even use your grenades. Let's say you enter this room and you might suspect there is enemy right in the next room. And normally they would also spot them quite fast, but again, same, if it's dark and whatever, you might take a lot of time. Sometimes you even don't see them until you enter the room, if they're in some height status or whatever, and the weather is bad, low light conditions, you might not see them, and they will start to uncharge their weapons. And it, I think, from my experience, but I don't take it for and take it with a grain of salt, it has also some recon by fire effect. Recon by fire is you fire on some suspected enemy position, and the enemy reacts and gives you evidence that he is there, basically. You know, it's from reconnaissance, they sometimes fired into bushes, and if somebody fired back, or if somebody started to run out of this bush, you knew, yes, there is somebody. And I've noticed some sort of this effect here too, but could be, I don't know, could be not true. Sometimes it gave me the impression that they start to react, I don't know, and this causes them to become faster spotted. So you enter the room and it is dark, whatever, and you know there's some, might be a guy beside that. You see that not even everybody was entering the room. Some were still at the door, and the line was gray, which means not true or partial LOS, LOF, whatever. You can already give the command, and when they enter, they will start immediately to fire into the neighboring room. And sometimes happens that people still, but they are okay. They're veterans. Yeah, but this cause. Keep in mind, only 30 seconds ago, somebody was shot, so this might be still the remnant of the situation. That's what I call pre-firing, or you can call it what you want, that's my own name to it. Because you basically recon by fire, and recon by fire is not really shooting it, because he's also thinking now he's reloading. Don't know, can they use grenades from inside? That would be interesting. See if somebody is prepping a grenade at some point. This guy is a philosopher, it seems. What the hell is this guy? Is it the squad leader? Yes. Okay, he's directing the action. Might also depend on the building type, whatever, but I'm not sure if it. Yeah. That's quite hilarious. It's a funny guy, comedy man, but let alone by the small arms fire, should already cause quite a suppression effect, and then go for entering the room either by what I explained, use what suits you. I notice I'm often using quick. I don't know. I know others say use almost exclusively hunt for stuff like this, which would make sense. Naturally, I also would hunt into the room. Not sure if I would run into the room, but you know, there is tactics like this. There is talked where you basically enter the room, clear the doorway, and you will enter. There's not standing there. You will enter and might discharge your weapon, but you will not stand in the door frame, because doorways, because universal rule of CQC or MOUT is doorways will kill you. And yeah, I could also do this. It's of course slower, but they also have a better situation awareness when you suppress guys inside there. However, the problem is, once they spot something, they will basically stop immediately, and that's why I often use quick. And because they will stop, and you see sometimes they bunch up at the doorways, and if some machine gunner spots them first, he might gun them completely down. And fast, yeah, let's enter the room. I mean, it could be also if they cancel the hunt, and they might still spread out in the room. They won't lay down in the doorway. Normally they disperse to the next room. But still, if you one room, if you compare this to Quick. Yeah, okay, I've seen better Quick movements. There's some shot because they all enter in the center, but often you have this disperse effect. This would be the worst. You know, perfect would be this and stuff like this, and then this, but yeah, it's still fine. And sometimes they even do something similar. It depends on the situation. Yeah, but that's the two tactics you could keep in mind, especially on some situations we talked about. Yeah, I think that's it.